aerosol cans by Austin, Melissa, Nora, and Nick.
Norwegian engineer Erik Rothen files patent for the aerosol dispenser. It was mass-produced in World War II for Americans to fight insect-borne diseases in the Pacific. Soon after, manufactured for civilian applications. At first, it was mainly used for insecticides and hairspray, but soon it included air fresheners, deodorants, and shaving foams. The aerosol industry reached the golden age in the 1960s. Environmental concerns. In the 70s, the aerosol can was put at the forefront of the concern of the thinning ozone. It was blamed because of its contained CFCs, or chlorofluorocarbon. CFCs were banned in the Montreal Protocol, and since the 80s, aerosol cans have not contained any. The chemistry. Aerosol is suspension of fine, solid, or liquid particles and gas. Aerosol cans are a mechanism designed to turn a liquid into a finely dispersed mist. They are kept at 2 to 8 times normal atmosphere pressure.
Aerosol cans contain two different substances, a liquid product and pressured gas, the propellant. When forced inside the can, it usually turns into a liquid. The propellant and the product mix, and the propellant turns back into a gas, and pressure is released. What about the cans themselves? Mainly made of metals that can contain pressure, examples being steel with a tin coating. Environmentally friendly plastic coatings are increasing in this use. Carbon dioxide, propane, and butane are all used as propellants. If any is left in the can upon disposal, great environmental risks can occur. Rusting of these cans can cause leaking of the dangerous chemicals. Puncturing of the cans can cause the pressure inside to release and explode. Also, intense heat can cause an explosion.
Oh, and they're flammable.
Phase 2 of this shootout will be Brake Clean versus Carb Clean. Okay. Ready? See, now that's good. That is some distance right there. Okay.
Wow.
Okay. Should we see this one?
No, I'm holding the lighter while Freiberger uses something.
At least I'm not aiming it towards you.
Yeah.
Oh, man!
Burned hand? Not burned hand. This one's a little tingly.